Hello, everyone. I'm Joshua.
And I'm Abe.
Amanda.
I'm Jay.
I'm Josh, too.
Another one I got here, which honestly I have not seen at all. I've never seen this, and that's the remake of the original Night of the Living Dead. And you know, I've seen the first one. I really love the original movie. I have not seen the remake. I know it's directed by Tom Savini, and which I did meet Tom Savini, by the way, at one of the film festivals I went to. So yeah, I may end up watching this. I'll probably watch this after I, like, watch the remakes of George Romero's zombie movies, like this, the Dawn of the Dead one, and that. After I've, you know, reviewed all the original George A. Romero movies, so. Which a lot of them I have not seen. I've only seen the first one, and that's Night of the Living Dead, so. Of the original, so. I have not seen Dawn of the Dead through Survival of the Dead. I have not seen those. So. The next one I got here is for documentary, which is an awesome documentary. If you're a horror fan, especially a fan of this specific franchise, I highly recommend it. Especially getting the 2-disc collector's edition, and that's for Never Sleep Again, The Elm Street Legacy. This one is an awesome documentary. It's from the same people who made the Crystal Lake Memories documentary. Except this one covers the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. Except they left out the remake. Not sure why. I'm not sure if that's because this came out before the remake did. Let's see. Not seeing the release date on here at all. Oh wait, actually it came out afterwards. This came out in 2014. So maybe because it's like the remake was so panned and everything that they decided to, you know, shove it under the rug. Although, maybe that, it could have been maybe good, actually, to include it. Maybe they could have gotten insights as far as what went wrong, you know, all the production issues the film had, and just what, you know, interviewed the cast and crew of the movie, and, you know, because even some of them had really bad experiences. Like, I've heard Rooney Mara really hated working on the film so much, too, where she almost quit acting. So, that would have been really interesting to cover, actually, in this documentary, but they did not, so. So, yeah, Never Sleep Again. I highly recommend it for any Fred heads out there. Or just people who just are really into horror in general. I highly recommend it. Or, you know, especially if you're into filmmaking and that. It gives you a lot of really great insight. So, highly recommend it. So. Next one I got here is for a film I have seen. And that's the remake of My Bloody Valentine 3D. The disc is just plain. I wish there could have been a better design for the disc. But honestly, for me, in my opinion, I don't want to spoil my thoughts on this movie, actually, because I'm, you know, currently watching the original movie for the first time, which I'll review that, and then afterwards rewatch this. Rewatch this and then review that. see my thoughts change after watching the original for the first time. But, yeah, so, My Bloody Valentine 3D, the remake.
Mama?
So, here's the movie Mama, which I actually did saw this in the theater. I remember liking it okay. You know, it was okay. You know, I didn't love it. I didn't hate it. I just thought it was decent. At least when I saw it in theater. And I haven't seen the movie since. I am probably going to do a review of this. See if my thoughts changed on it at all. So, and the one thing I do know is it is directed by the same guy who directed the two new It movies. The one from 2017 and this year. So, and he even stars Jessica Chastain, who was the adult version of Buffy in It Chapter 2. So yeah, I found that really interesting, so. Now, moving on to the next pile, I got a double feature, and that's for Jason X and Jason Goes to Hell, which I remember, I've only seen these movies like once maybe in full, and Jason Goes to Hell I think is a really bad movie from what I remember, like probably my least favorite in the series, and Jason X, it's bad, but I think it's so bad in an entertaining sort of way. And plus, Uber Jason's pretty fucking cool, I will admit. In fact, actually, cooler and better design than what he looked like before the transformation, so. Here's another double feature, and that includes Friday 13th Part 7, The New Blood. And Friday 13th Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. Now, honestly, for me, these movies are kind of forgettable. The only thing worth remembering is Part 7 with, you know, the character of Tina, who is basically, you know, their version of Carrie, basically a rip-off version of Carrie from Stephen King's story, you know. I mean, it technically was Jason versus Carrie. That's really all it was. And this was the first introduction to Kane Hodder, Jason, which he's actually pretty awesome as Jason. I actually did got to meet him. So, and honestly, he was super nice when I met him. So, yeah. So Kane. So, the first two installments with Kane Hodder as Jason. Part 8 completely forgettable. Part 7, only thing worth remembering is that it was practically Jason versus Carrie. That's all from what I remember of these two movies, so, yeah. Next one I got is actually a Blu-ray double feature, and that's for Friday 13th Part 5, A New Beginning, and Friday 13th Part 6, Jason Lives. Now, actually, I do like both of these movies, actually. They're not great movies by any means, but they're really fun movies, actually. So, yeah. Again, I'll be more in-depth when I get to these reviews, so. I still need to finish watching Friday 13 Part 3 and then review that and review all the rest of the films. So, yeah. The next one I got is a triple feature, and that's for the first four movies. Now, I've already reviewed the first two, and if you want to know my more in-depth thoughts on the first two, you could go and check out my review series playlist. But I'm in the middle of watching part three, like I said. And, you know, the first four movies are honestly pretty good. I do have issues with some of them. So, yeah. There's that. Now, the next one I got is another film collection set. Now, I only saw the first one of these. I haven't checked out the others. And that's the Dracula Complete Legacy Collection. And this is what the old classic Universal Monsters, you know, movies. The first one with Bela Lugosi's Dracula right there. I saw the first one, and honestly, the first one is really good. It's probably the oldest movie I've ever seen. It came out in 1931. And it was really good, actually. I may do a review of that. But I haven't seen the other ones. This includes also Dracula's Daughter, Son of Dracula, House of Frankenstein, House of Dracula, and Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein. It also includes a bonus feature, 1931 Spanish version of Dracula. So it includes like documentaries and that, like The Road to Dracula, Lugosi the Dark Prince. There's also an alternate score for the first movie. And it includes free feature commentaries and that. It's loaded with a lot of special features. So I'd highly recommend picking this up, especially if you're a Dracula fan or just love the Universal Monster stuff. So I may probably pick up the other ones like Frankenstein, The Wolfman, and that. Because I haven't seen those movies, so yeah. The next one I got, I haven't seen. I got this recently, and that's Don't Breathe. Now, I heard a lot of good things about this movie, so I'm honestly kind of interested in checking it out. So, and I've heard what it's about, and it does kind of interest me, actually. So, I may end up doing a review of this movie, more than likely. Normally what I do with these movies is, depending on how first of all, I watch them, review them, and after uploading the review to my channel, I'm like, depending on how I feel about said movie, if it's a movie I feel like I can absolutely never get rid of, then I keep it, you know, it really depends on that too, because it's like, if anybody else I know, like my friends and that, have said movie already, and to where I could watch it when I hang out with them and that, then, you know, then I end up selling it. But if they do not, then yeah, I'm keeping it. So, or if or if my brother has said movies, then I sell or trade that in. So, or even if I again have it on like Vudu Movies and that, or if it's on Netflix or stuff like that, so. And basically trade or sell them for movies I don't got, and so. So yeah, Don't Breathe, so. The next one I got is another one I haven't seen. This is yet another James Wan directed movie. Now, honestly, for me, you know, James Wan for me kind of ranges in quality sometimes. Sometimes he's really great. Like, the best ones he's done for me is, I think, honestly, personally for me, is Saw, the original. I think he did a really good job with Dead Silence. And he did a really great job on Aquaman. So, those are so far the ones I think are really good. Now, I haven't seen every single James Wan directed movie, but those to me are the best. There's some that are just okay. Like, the first two Insidious movies are just okay, honestly. And I you know, for me, that's one series I honestly could see being remade and done a lot better. The biggest problem I had with those movies was execution and some of the design work in it, so, like... Which, for me, if I were to remake Insidious, that's probably the things I would do. I'd probably have it be a different story, but keep some of the ideas and concepts relatively the same. While maybe doing something new, like give my own style and flair to them. And just, you know, just doing a lot of stuff I think would have been done, like, I think I probably would do a lot better. And the film I got here is one I haven't seen yet. That's from him. As far as I know, it's not horror. It's some type of suspense, thriller, whatever. And that's Death Sentence. Came out the same year that Dead Silence did, 2007. Haven't seen this. The most I know about it stars Kevin Bacon. So I am really interested in checking this out, reviewing it.